You know, the heartbeat of our plant is our boiler systems. If we don't have the boilers running properly and the right fuel going to the boilers, our whole operation doesn't run. We need to create heat. We actually had a retrofitted corn or grain conveyor where we used a metal fabricated hopper where we dumped wood chips into that conveyor and it fed it up into the drop chute. The boiler operator spending 60% of his time in a loader feeding fuel when he could have been in the building doing things, monitoring equipment, preventative maintenance, making sure the systems were running efficiently. So that was huge. So when we took out that kind of self-made archaic setup, we changed over obviously a simple smart conveyor system, and it has saved 60% of that time.
We were looking to put in a little more reliable conveyor. We had some conveyors we had built actually under our pellet mills to convey everything from the pellet mill itself to into the cooler, but we were having some problems, and we saw the biomass advertisement and saw how the way the chains were ride in the conveyor and the way they don't ride on the chain on the bottom of the conveyor. It looked like something we wanted to try out.
As I say, I think that most elegant solutions are the simple ones. And when you look at one of our sections of conveyor and you see how few parts there are to that, you say, this has been refined a bit.
The best aspects are one, it works. It works really well compared to other ways of conveying wood waste. Two, it's very low maintenance, and the maintenance that it does need is really simple. It's running 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. So, you know, 1 year is really elongated in terms of what you use for it.
The smart conveyor is designed so that the chains are totally supported the entire length of the conveyor on a plastic wear strip, which makes it move very efficiently. So there's no metal to metal contact in our conveyors except where the chain goes around the sprocket. Our paddles don't touch the floor or sidewalls, and therefore, our energy is used to move material, not overcome friction. We've gone out in the field and seen conveyors from other companies with patches upon patches upon patches welded on the sides of the conveyors. That's not gonna happen with our designs.
If something does go wrong or wear out in, you know, an hour or two, you can change all the elbows out and all the slide parts. And the low operating cost, I mean, it's a low horsepower conveyor. It doesn't have a lot of, you don't have a big starter or a big motor. A lot easier to change a 2 or 5 horse motor than it is a 20 or 40.
What seems to be the simplest piece of the operation shuts down the rest of the operation. Suddenly it became a very important thing. We are really focused on the operational cost. We're focused on that uptime, minimizing downtime, making maintenance simple and fast. When you do have a failure, make it quick and easy to fix what failed. Put it back to operation as fast as possible. We can't build the world's best conveyor and also be the cheapest conveyor. So we have to get people over that initial upfront capital cost, but it's that operational cost where we always win. It's the cost of installation. These conveyors install super fast because of that modular nature. It's that low maintenance cost, and even when you have to do maintenance, it's simple and anybody can do it and they can do it quickly. It's low energy cost. Customers will come back, look at our bid, and they'll look at someone else's bid and they see that we're half of the horsepower. Rest easy, after a few hundred of these and everybody has told us the same thing, we're pretty confident we're just lower horsepower. We've always tried to make our designs modular so that if you buy something from us today, if you come back 10 years from now, 20 years from now, and you need to modify it in some way, you're not coming to us to buy another conveyor. You're coming for add-ons to that, or maybe we add a curve here or add a section there or put a bigger gear motor on. If I can cut his upfront engineering costs, if I can reduce his installation costs, well, I'm gonna add another level of value that's just gonna make us a priceless partner.
On a week-to-week basis, there's a lot of other aspects of the plant that I do stress about and wake up at night wondering, did we check that? Are the chains good? Are the paddles bending? And I don't really worry about the biomass conveyors. They are one of my bread and butters that I don't have to stress about.